This week on Animal Nations, we enter the perilous world of the American high school to observe its inhabitants. Join me as we cross the threshold from the civilized world to this delicate yet dangerous ecosystem to observe the behaviors of these savages in their natural habitats. As with many of the territories we observe, we have to be very careful not to disturb the fragile balance. The average high school student is quite self-conscious and spooks very easily. Come join us while we observe.
Who are you here to see?
We're here to observe.
I'm sorry?
We're here to observe.
Observe what?
We want to film students in their natural habitat.
This isn't for film club, is it?
No.
Good, I'll buzz you in.
While our first species is quite often considered to be the weakest, they are frequently the most intelligent, which leads them to be alienated and create a class system all their own. They are most often characterized by their confused fashion sense, lack of friends, thick-rimmed glasses, and geek speak.
Dude, you're owning.
OMG, an essay.
Dude, where'd the essay go?
I don't know. I hit him with a few stuns off my bashers. He should be gone.
Did you kill him?
Well, no, but he had to have been low. He's probably back at his base regenerating.
Dude, this is a level 16 essay we're talking about. He has a 1 second fade time. He could be anywhere.
Don't worry, he got hit. He won't do anything.
Don't worry, what if there's a regen rune in the river? I'm sitting up here farming some creeps. What if he SBs me and blinks me and I'm dead?
Calm down, it's gonna be okay. You're level 18 Lena. You're gonna own him.
Dude, I'm an int hero. Ugh.
Your hero has fallen.
OMG. Are you happy now? I got you into this game.
Is there a problem?
Ask the noob.
It's not my fault. I didn't know the SA was gonna kill him. Right?
Golf is too a sport.
Yeah, right, give me a break.
Within the job genus, there's a complex hierarchy, sometimes causing the more powerful to prey upon the weaker. Those lesser may use ingenuity and their resources to survive.
Golf. My grandmother plays golf. Why don't you play a real sport like football? Check this out. This is what you get from playing a real sport.
Yeah, you tell him. He's too busy chasing a little ball around with a stick.
Yeah.
It's the government, man. Like, they put chips on your arms and they can track you and they'll know everything about you.
Like chips?
Exactly, man.
Like Funyuns, man?
Funyuns. What?
I like Funyuns.
That's cool, but I'm talking about...
We like need Velcro, man. What's for lunch today?
It's tacos.
Sweet, man. You know what this school needs more of?
Less government interference?
No! More Funyuns.
Fight the power.
Although most students are confined to classrooms, we will most often find band geeks roaming the halls, armed with only a pass for protection. Traveling in packs offers more protection.
Ooh, face paint.
Available at the Meteor Spirit Store, open lunch periods Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
That's up to you, talk to each other.
stranded, a band geek will use its cunning and camouflage.
Dude, you smell that?
No.
Smells like Mountain Dew and nut rolls.
And valve oil.
Band geeks.
Here we see the cheerleader bringing the alpha male its sustenance. Though the jock is able to procure its own food, it often chooses not to.
Hey, how are you doing?
Hey,
I guess we're going on tonight,
Saturday. Yeah, we are.
If a cheerleader becomes threatened by another of her kind, she may be aggressive. Be aggressive.
You're gonna get
smoked. It's on. Ow, stop! My mom hurts! I got more
hurt you!
Stop pulling on my hair!
That's awesome.
Cheerleading is too a sport!
Dogbeat! Easily recognizable by their brand name clothing, preps are a result of long lines of high class breeding and cultural learning. They have refined taste in food, art, and fashion, and a longing for social acceptance. However, when left to fend for themselves without parental protection, they're somewhat ill-equipped.
Wait, what do you mean my card's been declined? You mean I can't buy that Louis Vuitton bag?
Oh my gosh, what happened?
My parents put $1,000 limit on my card.
What are you going to do?
I don't know, but I'm not going to the club looking like her.
The redneck syntax is often incoherent to other species in its environment. The identifiable traits of a redneck are its unique tracks and molds and camouflage, not at all useful in the high school environment.
NASCAR is too a sport.
It's right there, like 8 points, but I couldn't get the shot.
That 492 around the outside, about to take the lead.
So Skeet, he gets on his quad and cuts around the logging trail.
And he will not let them pass.
So he cuts around the outside, scares Buck back my way.
Fixing to win his first in the Nextel series, something no one else on his team's ever done. Get her done! Get her done!
There he is, right in my sights.
Engine blows!
Boom!
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 Takes one for the team.
Right between the eyes.
He got her done. It was beautiful. Get her done! Get her done! And there it was in front of me. Whole flock of deer.
Herd.
What?
Herd of deer.
Yeah, I heard a deer. And I seen them too. Whole flock of them. Sweet home Alabama. That's a blue-crested Skinner turkey. And my gun's in my truck.
You can't bring a gun in school.
No, it's okay. They're in season.
The loverless leechmas is incapable of surviving without its mate and must be in constant contact at all times or to risk the threat of immediate death. Signs of their symbiotic relationship are evident in many forms.
When you're writing an informative paper, there are three steps you have to keep in mind. The pre-writing stage, the writing stage, and the evaluation and revision stage. Is everyone...
It's okay. I'm just looking on with her.
I'm gonna have to check the handbook on that, but I guess, for now, till I do. Yeah.
Although the couple seems to thrive on the attention that they receive from their mate, their affection can have quite the opposite effect on others.
Disgusting.
Some animals are completely misplaced in their species, so much so that they roam the cold wastelands with no pack, allies, or mate. But fear not, there is a habitat for these pathetic animals hidden within the jungle of the junior high.
Alright, so we have to represent each of the cliques in the school. We need jocks first. Does anybody have a varsity jacket?
Anyone?
Anyone have a varsity jacket? Alright, anybody know anybody with a varsity jacket? Holland?
Yeah, the guy who takes my lunch money has one. This is not for use on skin.
Huh. Well, the next we have to make fun of ourselves. So is there anything you guys can think of that's like geeky or weird about us that we could make fun of? Because I really don't think I know of anything that we could be made fun of for. Hey, Kyle, Steve, you guys got any ideas?
Dude, my arm.
It's supposed to be your right arm.
Dude, no, it's the left.
By the obvious Jedi-oriented techniques you employed, it is clear that it is the Dooku versus Anakin battle of Episode 2.
But the blocking moves I enacted were clearly passed down from ancient Sith moves, which obviously were taught to Anakin by Palpatine, which means it was the Obi-Wan-Anakin battle of Episode 3.
With ideas like that, you probably still think Wookiees live on Endor.
Nuh-uh.
Trekkie.
Blasphemy.
Steve and Kyle, could you just sit down?
You don't want me to sit down.
Okay, I'll sit down.
Thank you. What's next?
There's lead in this.
I'll be your friend.
All right, it looks here like the next scene we have is the redneck scene. Does anybody have a shirt with like NASCAR on it, maybe? No, anything with a fast car on it, a race car of any sort. How about a shirt with anything that goes fast on it?
Ooh!
And not the Millennium Falcon, Steve. Sorry.
This is starting to burn. My face is burning. Ah! Ow!
Okay, so how about the geek scene? Is anybody here familiar with online gaming?
Ooh.
Oh, wow. You.
So what have we learned here at the American High School? Just like the Animal Kingdom, the American High School students have developed their own hierarchy, or pecking order, and each new generation falls into the same patterns that have served their predecessors so effectively.
Excuse me.
Can I help you?
I think there's a misprint here.
And what word is that?
This one right here.
Rowdy? Oh, and what's wrong with it?
It's spelled wrong.
Well, how do you spell it?
R-O-W-D-I-E. That's the way we spell rowdy. Rowdy. Let's get rowdy.
Woo! Just put the dictionary back.
And if Darwin was right, well, you figure it out. Next time on Animal Nations, we join the American High School students as they forage for food.
There's no Mountain Dew. Where's the Mountain Dew? Oh man. Where are they, man? Come on. It's not funny, man. Who took them? Who took my Funyuns? Where are they? Can't see the Funyuns. It's not cool. That's not funny, man. Where are the Funyuns, man? Someone took them. Where'd they go? I want some Funyuns. You! Hey, take my Funyuns!